you hold me and kiss me slowly, it's the sweetest thing. And it don't change. If I had it my way, you would know that you are. You're the coffee that I need in the morning. You're my sunshine in the rain when it's pouring. Won't you give yourself to me? Give it all. Oh, I just wanna see. I just wanna see how beautiful you are. You know that I see it. I know you're a star. Where you go, I'll follow. No matter how far. If life is a movie.
I'm gonna wish you guys many, many years and an abundance of years of just love and just growth between you two. And you know, I'm not gonna be sleeping on the couch anymore, but I'm always family, and I can't wait to just watch your family grow and, you know, have my family join your family. And I love you both.
Ryan, Morgan, congratulations from the Galantes. We're so excited to be here with you guys tonight and be a part of your journey from the first day you guys met. So congratulations. We love you guys.
Love you guys.
Hi, Morgan and Ryan. Wishing you many years of happiness.
Congratulations, congratulations, Morgan. We're happy to celebrate your special day with you. And we wish you guys all the happiness.
We're very happy for you. We wish you nothing but a happily ever after.
Congratulations. Welcome to the family, Ryan. You're gonna love it.
Year 14, 15 of the day. I hope you guys make sweet, sweet love tonight and have a great, great rest of your life. Amen.
I'm an 8-year-old boy. Last night I went to a carnival and I made a wish to be older. And I woke up this morning in the body of a 29-year-old man. Somebody come help me. I've attended this wedding. The bride and groom seemed lovely. But I'm trapped. Okay, congratulations, guys.
I love you. Mwah!
Many happiness. I love you guys. I can't wait to grow old together. You're perfect. We're perfect. I love you.
We love you guys. Good luck.
Love you so much.
Ryan, you never change. Sexy beast.
Big congratulations. Really happy that we're all able to come up to Saratoga this weekend to celebrate, and wish you guys the best of luck. Love you so much.
Best wishes, guys. We're so excited this day is finally here. Can't wait to celebrate with you. Cheers.
We are so proud of both of you. It's just amazing.
Come. I will give you your true name and I will change my phone contact for you, and it will finally be Ryan's wife. Thank you.
We're
so happy for you, and thanks for having us as part of your special day.
Happy to be here, and I love you both, and congratulations from Denzel.
We just love you so much, and thank you so much for showing us such a good time, and we just love you. Mwah.
You guys are a wonderful couple. We wish you many, many years of love and happiness.
You guys are amazing, and I love you.
We love you.
Congratulations.
I'm so happy you both found your best friends, and I deeply cherish your friendship, and I wish you a lifetime of love and hard-earned happiness together.
Wish you many years of happiness, joy, love.
Brian and Morgan, congratulations on your beautiful marriage and wedding. And it was a pleasure living with you guys for a couple of years there. And thank you for always watching Carson.
Please put your hands together for Bob and Lisa Esseri. For the parents of the groom, Maurice and Michelle Baird. Okay, listen. I want you to be so loud that you can be heard from space, all right? And while you're at it, why don't you grab those handkerchiefs and spin them around? Okay, here we go, here we go. All right, oh, looking good, looking good. Here we go. Friends and family, please make some noise for Mr. and Mrs.
See how beautiful you are. You know that I see it. I know your star. All right. Up next, we have our parent dances, starting with the father and the bride.
Who would be the most successful in life? whose house is nicer, who mom and dad liked better. Everything was a competition. I'm happy to say this has turned into us supporting each other's dreams, and that I live far enough away that I don't have to keep up with you and PJ going out on the weekends. My grandma always used to tell me that I would be so grateful to have a sister one day, and I think she'd be pretty happy with where we are now. Granted, it took about 25 years and some loser boys to realize that I needed her support and love, but I'm glad that it wasn't a puppy all those years ago. Mostly glad. There have been a lot of milestones in the past couple of years for us, and it wouldn't be half as special if I wasn't able to share it with them. I'm so proud of the woman you have become, and I can't wait to see what you do in the future. It is my duty as the older sister to dislike Ryan before even meeting him. And I took this job very seriously. Nothing against you at all. Now, Ryan also helped by showing up to every Docs Out Saturday very hungover. Falling asleep at 7 p.m. on the one time they visited us in Vermont. And something about the AC leaking through the brand new ceiling in their house. And he was friends with PJ. Take that as you will. Always the comic relief, though. Feel free to walk off the dock into the November Mohawk River anytime. However, over the past few years, I've gotten to know Ryan and his family, and watch him and Morgan create their own family together. I see the smile you put on my dad's face, even if most of the time he's laughing at you. I see the way Morgan looks at you, even beyond the scowl. Perhaps most importantly, I see the way you love her and watch out for her, and that's all a big sister needs. I'm so glad that you're part of our growing family, and I'm even more grateful that this baby gets to have you two as man. I'd like to leave you with a few pieces of advice from my very long 11 months of marriage. Don't sweat the small stuff, and it's mostly small stuff. Stay friends, even during the hard times. This is going to be the person next to you at the very best of times and the very worst. Don't forget that and always treat each other with respect. And lastly, if you're going to fight naked. It's hard to say that.
Sum this story up. Who Ryan is to me can be summed up in a story that happened 20 years ago. Set the scene with, I just learned how to ride my bike. We're riding up and down the hill right in front of our house. And I wanted to follow Ryan's lead as closely as possible. I'm really not coordinated, I'm like maybe 6 or 7. And so we're going up and down the hill, I'm trying to follow him really close. And right in the middle of the hill is the Held's house. And the Held's house had a wooden fence right by the driveway, and there's 2 leaf bags. And I just swerved right into that thing, and it felt like I was going 60 miles per hour. I crashed into a tree, and I'm twisted in this wooden fence, and I'm screaming, I'm scraped up, and there's this picture in my head of Ryan. He throws his bike in the lawn, and he runs over me, and he literally picks me up, and he carries me all the way to the washroom. And my mom tended to me, nice mom. And I always thought I was just like a core member. But like, perfect timing. The universe speaks to us like 2 weeks later. In second grade, we had to write about who our hero was. And I wrote about that moment in particular. And I said, the only thing I wrote was, Ryan is my hero because Ryan carried me. And Ryan continues to carry me throughout every day of my life. He's my best friend. He's my confidant. He pushes me to be my best. He's my guy. And so me and Ryan both went to Santa, and he's the reason why I went. And it was funny because Ryan's so extroverted that my friends actually independently met my brother before I could even introduce them. And they always say, like, oh, we're going to hang out with the mayor tonight. We're going to see the mayor. And I'm like, who is the mayor? And they're like, there's this guy named Ryan. And I was like, that's my brother. What are you talking about? Why do you call him the mayor? And they were just like, oh, he's a politician. He knows everybody. He shakes everybody's hand. Like, everyone's happy to see him. And, you know, for those who don't know my brother pretty well, that's a really good description of my brother. So, but if we back this up even further, on a more intimate level, he's my brother. He's really someone who's dynamic. I would say that Ryan's really savvy. He's someone who's quick. He's charismatic. He makes everything entertaining. He charges the mood. It's great. And what's great about Ryan is he's so inclusive. Nobody's truly beneath him. You know, and you can talk to Ryan about philosophy, or you can do like pot shot, lowbrow humor. It doesn't matter. You can reach him at any level. So let's back this up for a second. If you were to ask anybody, okay, what is the ideal man? They probably list sort of these characteristics. They'd say the ideal man is somebody who's competitive, successful, confident, productive, and assertive. And I would say that Ryan has probably mastered all those traits by the age of 20. I'd probably say that. But I would say, over all of that, there's a missing trait for that list. And I would say, what makes a true man is balance. And I would say that Morgan has brought out balance in my brother. Morgan has truly, you know, elevating my brother to be more, more thoughtful, responsible, more self-accountable. And you truly lifted Ryan in this way to make him a more complete man. So I want to back it up to say, like, who is Morgan? So Morgan is someone who is extremely consistent. You have a strong sense of character. And you push improvement, you know, you have high standards, and that's great. You know, you elevate our family, you make us better. And together, I would say you guys are such just a nice, powerful duo. And you guys make community possible. And I just, like, look around. You see everybody here, you see a lot of family, you see a lot of friends. This is a true community. And you think about the ways that they've inspired each other. They made a house a home. You traveled to some pretty unique places. Now, officially, as of like 2 hours ago, you've solidified two families into one. And that's really special. And now, maybe you guys will create your own, if that's what you're willing to do. So, it's great. So, Ryan and Morgan, I want you guys specifically, just take a moment, I want you to look around at the home. So, this is the community you guys have built and supported, and now it's our turn. It's our turn for the next 60 plus years. To support and help you guys every step of the way, and we're all honored to share this experience with you, and we're very thankful for you. So, if I may, to love, happiness, and community, thank you.
What you get?
I said, what you see is what you get.